I almost feel bad. I almost feel bad now. I managed to open the lock. Are you two... Oh my god. Metaton! Metaton! Are you... Thank god, it's just the batteries. Metaton, if you were gone, I would have... I mean, hey, it's no problem. You know, he's just a robot. You messed it up. I could always just build another. Why don't you go on ahead? Okay. It's out of batteries. That's it. It's really just out of batteries. Fair enough. It's just out of batteries, guys. There's no field strip. That's going to be fine. Uh-oh. Sorry about that. Let's keep going. Oh, okay. So I have another dinosaur friend now. So you're about to meet Asgore, huh? You must be pretty excited about all that, huh? I mean, I would seem so. You'll finally get to go home. Yep. Wait. I mean, I was just going to say goodbye, and I can't take this anymore. I lied to you. A human soul isn't strong enough to cross a barrier alone. It takes at least a human soul and a monster soul. If you want to go home, you'll have to take his soul. You'll have to kill Asgore. I'm sorry. Killing anyone. So how do we do that? I mean, I can't kill him though. Now I'm confused. But I can't kill him if I want to do a pacifist playthrough. I just saved. Why would I save again? It's a golden flower. Why am I back here? A long time ago, a human fell into the ruins. Injured by its fall, the human called out for help. You took the key and put it on your phone's keychain. Azrael, the king's son, heard the human's call. He brought the human back to the castle. There's a heart-shaped locket inside the box. Will you take it? It's in a present. Maybe I'm supposed to have it. There's a worn dagger inside the box. Will you take it? Room under renovation. Over time, Azrael and the human became like siblings. The king and queen treated the human child as their own. The underground was full of hope. Asgore's journal. All the current pages say, is nice today. The ink is still almost wet. The trophy, number one, Nose Nuzzle Champs, 1998. With a Santa Claus outfit inside, nice. Fine, I'll grab the stupid dagger. I'm not doing a pacifist playthrough. I don't know why I would take a dagger, but... But thanks for letting me play my own game, guys. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Totally love that stuff. Love it when I feel like a game got kind of fucked up for me because somebody told me what to do. It's awesome. It's a king-size bed. That's what I sleep on. Let's see. All right. I mean... You lol, but I'm being pretty serious, Taz. Like, what am I... Like, now I can't ignore that, so I have to do that. I mean, frankly, I'd be bounds for a timeout, frankly, but, I don't know. Then one day, the human became very ill. What do I do? Oh, there we go. I was hitting the wrong things. The sick human had only one request, to see if the flowers from their village, but there was nothing we could do. This music is awesome right now. The next day, the human died. Azrael, racked with grief, absorbed the human soul. He transformed into a being with incredible power. With the human soul, Azrael crossed through the barrier. He carried the human's body into the sunset, back to the village of the humans. Azrael reached the center of the village. There, he found a bed of golden flowers. He carried the human onto it. Suddenly, screams rang out. The villagers saw Azrael holding the human's body. They thought that he had killed the child. Oh, shit. The humans attacked him with everything they had. He was struck with blow after blow. Azrael had the power to destroy them all. But Azrael did not fight back. Clutching the human, Azrael smiled and walked away. Wounded, Azrael stumbled home. He entered the castle and collapsed. His dust spread across the garden. The kingdom fell into despair. The king and queen had lost two children in one night. The humans had once again taken everything from us. The king decided it was time to end our suffering. Every human who falls down here must die. With enough souls, we can shatter that barrier forever. It's not long now. King Asgore will give us hope. King Asgore will let us go. King Asgore will save us all. You should be smiling, too. Aren't you excited? Aren't you happy? You're going to be free. Fucking hope so. Down here. Oh, shit. What the heck? Why am I back here? Wait, what the fuck? So I'm assuming I wasn't supposed to go this way, seeing as this is just a long, quiet hallway. Oh.
Why am I back in here? What did I do wrong?
Oh, it was a shortcut? Well, fucking A. So, I guess I'm just wasting time now walking up and down this hallway. Fair enough! Oh yeah, when horror games go quiet, you're like, fuck this, I'm out. Alright, well, I guess I gotta go through this whole thing again, huh? I'm not stalling, I went the wrong way, I had no fucking clue. So apparently... So I gotta go this way then? I have no idea where I'm supposed to go. Am I just going backwards now? I feel like I'm just going backwards. This is backwards. Where I came from? This is where I fucking came from. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? What the fuck am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to go down here? Okay. Oh, there's... Okay. Oh, see, I saw this pillar and I thought that that was the wall. So, okay, fair enough.
Blue, you're my boy!
Super Mario friends, thank you so much for that follow. And welcome to Blue's Crew. What's up, Kirby? Welcome. Really quiet. Really quiet. I don't know what to make of this. That looks like someone we know. Together, you will be determined the future of this world. That's then, now. You will be judged. You'll be judged for every action. You'll be judged for every experience you've earned. What's experience? It's an acronym. It stands for... Oh. Execution. Oh, I missed it. Way of quantifying the pain you have inflicted on others. When you kill someone, your
Blue,
EXP
you're
increases.
My boy!
Kirby, thanks for that follow, man. Welcome to Blue's Crew. When you have earned enough EXP, your love increases. Love, too, is an acronym. It stands for level of violence, a way of measuring someone's capacity to hurt. The more you kill, the easier it becomes to distance yourself. The more you distance yourself, the less you will hurt. The more easily you can bring yourself to hurt others. But you, yeah, I fucking knew it was Sans, but you never gained any love. Of course, that doesn't mean you're completely innocent or naive, just that you kept a certain tenderness in your heart. No matter the struggle or hardships you faced, you strive to do the right thing. You refuse to hurt anyone. Even when you ran away, you did it with a smile. You never gained love, but you gained love. Does that make sense? Maybe not. Now, you're about to face the greatest challenge of your entire journey. Your actions here will determine the fate of the entire world. If you refuse to fight, Asgore will take your soul and destroy humanity. But if you kill Asgore and go home, monsters will remain trapped underground. What will you do? Well, if I were you, I would have thrown in the towel by now, but you didn't get this far by giving up, did you? That's right. You have something called determination. So as long as you hold on, so as long as you do what's in your heart, I believe you can do the right thing. All right, we're all counting on you, kid. Good luck. I have no idea what I'm gonna do. How do I not kill Asgore? Throne room. Do I just let Asgore take me? That sounds kind of sexual, but that's not what I meant. That's the throne room. What else is around here? What's down here? I don't want to go in there yet. I want to know what's going on. Okay, now it got quiet. Oh, maybe this is where we were supposed to go. Well, fucking A, whatever. Dum-de-dum. Oh. Use someone there. Just a moment. I have almost finished watering these flowers. I think he's peeing. Here we are. Howdy. How can I... Oh, no. Oh. I so badly want to say, would you like a cup of tea? But you know how it is. Nice day today, huh? Birds are singing, flowers are blooming, perfect weather for a game of catch. You know what? You know what we must do? When you're ready, come into the next room. It's a throne. Lots of save points at this point. How tense. Just think of it like a visit to the dentist. Are you ready? If you are not, I understand. I am not ready either. Oh, too late. I already went. This is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If, by chance, you have any unfinished business, please do what you must. Alright, go somewhere. I see. Anything you want to do is important enough. Even something as small as reading a book or taking a walk. Please take your time. Alright, I'll go back. For a visit to the proctologist. Alright. There's a high level of ambiance in this area where they're very good about... See, when there's cracks in the wall, I feel like I should be able to interact with it. There's a high level of ambiance in this game. Even when it goes quiet, there's something. What on earth? It's a coffin. There's a name engraved on it. Blue. It's empty. Okay. A serious question, Dez? Okay. A proctologist is a butt doctor. So that's all I can do here, it would seem. So, unless... Well, doesn't seem like, it looks like they're just ready for me to die. I guess that's the point, is that they're just ready for me to die, and it looks like I'm the next in a chain of humans who have died in this arena, so... This doesn't seem like it's gonna be good. You know, I thought the same thing at first too, Rams, but... then I played a couple of other missions in other games and realized that, you know, when you can Battleborn, once you get better at it, goes faster. Back so soon. How are you feeling? Ready? Let's go. This is it, then. Well, I didn't equip the dagger. Ready? Journey is finally over. You're filled with determination. Human, it was nice to meet you. Goodbye. Oh, Lord. Well, I can't equip the... Oh, there it is. Shit. Oh, fuck me. Okay, this is gonna be rough, huh? You quietly tell Asgore you don't want to fight him. His hands tremble for a moment. Fuck me. Oh, I'm almost dead. Tell Asgore you don't want to talk. Really gets funny for a moment. I'm dead. I don't have a pie. Use the pie. I don't have a pie. I got nothing. I'm fucked. I'm fucked, man. Seems talking won't do any more good. Shit, I'm super dead. There you go. Yeah, I guess I ate the butt pie at some point. How on earth would you know to keep that? Stay determined. So I'm not really sure what to do at this point. I feel like I'm just going to get my ass whooped over and over again. Use the things, damn it. Shut up, ShadowCon. You have no idea what the fuck you're talking about. Oh, damn, ShadowCon. Whoops, that was a mistake. God, am I bad at this? Soggy won't do any more good. We can party when you pacify him? I don't know if I'm going to be able to. Whoops, that was super bad. I mean, I don't... I have no idea what to do. I mean, I don't think it matters what the bus pie is for. I don't have it, so it doesn't change anything right now. So if I just talk to him indefinitely, will anything change? Because at this point, all I can do is... Fuck, I couldn't... Yeah, I'm dead here. I'm terrible at this. Yeah, that's it. Slap the goat. Well, I'm not 100% sure what to do at this point. Yes, I'm ready. I think I'm going to talk him down until his defense drops. And then I guess I'm attacking him. You tell Asgore that he's killed you twice before. Whoa! Wait a minute. Oh, now I'm curious. Wait a minute. Shit. Damn it! I'm so bad at that. Oh shit, I didn't mean to talk again. Well, I took damage there. Yeah, the death counter's been off this whole time. I have no idea where we're at for deaths. Wait a minute. See, there was definitely... Whoops! Oh, I definitely fucked this up! Oh, it's real bad. There was definitely something different about that one. I told him that he had already killed me twice. It knows. It knows that I'm doing this. Aha! Got you that time, you sucker. Oh, now I'm dead. Whoa! Snuck through! Oh, yeah. Not the worst one, but it's not the... balls! But how do I finish this without killing anyone if I attack him? It doesn't make any sense. Eh, fuck. There's a blue in the middle there. I've never attacked anyone in this game. Oh, I didn't equip the knife. Better. Oh wait, am I trying to get it in the middle? I thought I was trying to get it in the green. That's how much I know. The very end of the tail hit me. He nods grievously. Wait a minute. I don't think he was nodding grievously before. Shit. Okay. like me. When I get this, regardless of how long this takes for whatever the fuck I'm trying to do right now, if you type one, it's one word. I know it's two words, but it's one word for this sake. In all caps, if you type out first try, it's my new BTTV emote. I want first tries spammed like crazy. Whatever happens, I have no idea how the fuck this is going to work, but I want first try spammed like crazy. The other thing I'm going to do is and I'll save that, man. That way I don't have to do that again. That's it, Preppy. Me. That was stupid. Fuck! I know. I know his eyes give away the swing pattern. I figured that out the first time he did that. I used to play Slither, guys. Those were the good days. I remember. Do you remember? I remember. Why did I... My God, this is tough. Obviously, you're not giving yourself mercy, so that definitely makes sense. Well, I mean, no, but Taz, that makes perfect sense. Like the only option in there to help me, the only option in there to help me is to flee, and this is clearly not a fight that I can flee. So, I think that's pretty straightforward. We'll be right back. I hit the button too soon. Shit. Get hit on those at all. Time to stop moving.
Blue, you're my boy!
Thank you for the follow. I can't wait. Wait. Is it Asteria? Is that what that is? Asteria, thanks so much for that follow.
Welcome to Blue's Crew.
I gotta give this game a lot of props, though, because, like, we all too often talk about, like, hard modes in games. Like, I play a lot of Destiny, and everyone's like, oh, I can't wait for the hard mode to come out. Ass Hysteria? Whatever, I don't know. But, this brings me back to when I was a kid, and to beat the boss, you and your brother or your friend or your cousin or whatever, you'd sit in the basement for 3 fucking days and play the same thing over and over again to beat the boss. You know what to do, but it's a matter of getting it done. Fracko212, thanks so much for that follow.
Welcome to Blue's Crew.
Are you in New York City? That's a 212. That's a New York City area code. Oh, I didn't do my shit. Wait a minute. Ah, okay. So I do actually do, like, fuck me. I think I might just throw this one away. See what happens. I'm not gonna talk to him. I'm just gonna go for it. Fuck me, I'm playing stupid now. I legitimately just forgot to talk to him, guys, so it's not like I didn't want to do it. This wasn't like a new strategy, I just forgot. I got into a rhythm. Hey, I got through that one. I struggled with that one, so. Fuck. Yo, Fracko, thanks so much for the host, man. Fuck! Hey, perfect hit. Blech. Less than I normally get. Oh, that's... I knew that was going down. Can I go all the way back to buy a healing thing? Is that an option? Like, is that a thing? I appreciate it, Thomas. We're good. We're clearly good. We're very much so good. So we're pretty good on all this stuff. Yeah, Thomas, we're good. We're good. Oh, Thomas is shushing a mod. Oh, this is going to go great. Jesus Christ, we got so many people coming. Oh my God, shut up, Rams. Shut up, Superman. How the fuck? I'm not even going to play the game. Where the hell do I go to even buy shit? I don't even know.
You're my boy!
Yo, event store, thanks so much for that follow, man.
Welcome to Blues Crew.
Again, guys, this is my virgin playthrough. I've never done this before, so junk food outside the hotel. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Caddy and Braddy. Isn't there a place in the hotel as well? But this is my first playthrough, and unless I ask for help, please don't. We've been pretty lackadaisical on spoilers so far, but I really need my mods to tighten down on spoilers, because problem. Jesus Christ, how far away? How fucking far do I have to go? Jesus. Oh, wait a minute. All right. All right. We made it all the way outside of the fucking hotel. Holy shit. I mean, I got a ton of gold. Should I just buy a whole bunch of these? Scott, is it your fucking birthday? Did I miss your birthday? God, I'm sorry I forgot about your birthday, dude. For the record, guys, Smatla, Scott, he's an IRL friend. Like, he's one of my best buds. I feel like such an asshole now. I'm sorry, Scott. I'm sorry. Happy birthday, man. I feel like such a dick now. He said it like two times. I'm sorry. I've been really focused. I feel like I have stuff that I really don't need to be carrying with me. Like, I don't even know what the old tutu is for. I get it. Yeah. Oh, drop it. I'm like going through this, like looking for a way to trade this shit in. Jeez, killing me. Well, now I feel stupid. Sorry, guys. Sorry that this is a little bit of a slow transition. We're getting there. We're getting there. Oh, this isn't so far away. We still have the long hallways to go down and stuff, but it's alright. And frankly, the way I've been playing, I should be able to get him first try now that I have 3 health drops, and I was trying to beat him with none, and I was getting more than halfway through. I don't really want to be attacking him. I feel like there's a solution, but... I feel like there has to be a solution where I don't shoot him or kill him. Oh yeah, no, don't worry, Evan Star. Trust me, I wouldn't forget that. Did I hear first try? Yeah. Yep. I'm like doing my best to like keep my cool. This is like, I feel like my regular's like, how is he not raging yet? I often can get kind of ragey at games, but here's the big thing. I say this a lot. What is it? One of the things that I say a whole lot is that I don't care. I hate more than anything else. I hate when a game doesn't tell me what I need to do, and I just don't know what to do. That's what I hate. But if I know what to do and it's frustratingly difficult, that's different. That's different. That's a totally different ballgame. So, in this case, I'm pretty stoked that I know what to do and it's just a challenge. No, I rage all the time. I rage all the time. And I used to be proud of myself for not raging, but as I started mixing my games up more, I started raging more because I was faced with new challenges, and a lot of the time I run into games that just don't have blue rants a lot. You guys are funny. You guys are funny because I rant all the time. Hence the Kappas. Blue never yells at people. I yell at people. I yell at people. But I hope that everybody knows when I yell at you, it's because of me. It's not because of you. It's because I'm frustrated. And I need to learn a better way to deal with that. Because every now and then I catch myself, like, after a stream being like, that was really mean. I shouldn't talk to people like that. Blue never says shut the fuck up to Tez. Well, sometimes, Tez, you gotta shut the fuck up, man. Did I just take the elevator? Did I really just take the elevator backwards? Fucking A. Well, shit. I don't know this map at all. You have a teammate who rages hard at NHL 17? I used to have a teammate that raged hard at Halo 5. Insider. That's an insider. I have no idea where to go, by the way. So I don't take the elevator, then, is what you're telling me. Damn mazes. Yep. I thought I had to take the elevator again, but I'm being... Ah, there we go. This stream has gone so long already, and it's just gonna keep going. Well, Tez, I want you to know that you're my buddy. But sometimes when you're in Discord, I'm like, dude, you gotta shut up. Like, and I've said that before, too, a lot. I've said to a lot of people, I'm just gonna save here just to be safe. I've said that to a lot of people where it's like, yo, this is my stream. It's nothing personal. It's just I can't get a word in edgewise. You're just going. And every now and then it turns into the Tez show, and I gotta shut that shit down. All right. Everyone get your first tries ready. Remember, it's first try, one word. It's the BTTV emote. Because we're doing this first try. It's going to keep going for 0.2 hours. It's definitely going to be 0.2 hours. Right, Orisk? It's like Oryx, but not. Moist try. He's killed you too many times to count. He nods pitifully. Aww. Ooh, I thought that was going to hit me for sure. Not what I meant to do. Shit. Okay, well, I got through it, but that is not what I meant to do. Fuck me. Alright. Shit. It's not a bot thing. Fuck. Fuck me. Holy balls! Ho-ho-ho! Getting better. That is how it is. I remember the day after my son died, the entire underground was devoid of hope. The future had once again been taken from us by the humans. In a fit of anger, I declared war. I said that I would destroy any human that came here. I would use their souls to become godlike and free us from this terrible prison. Then I would destroy humanity, and I let monsters rule the surface in peace. Soon the people's hopes returned. My wife, however, became disgusted with my actions. She left this place, never to be seen again. Truthfully, I do not want power. I do not want to hurt anyone. I just wanted everyone to have hope. But I cannot take this any longer. I just want to see my wife. I just want to see my child, please, young one. This war has gone on long enough. You have the power. Take my soul and leave this cursed place. Promise you, for as long as you remain here, my wife and I will take care of you as best we can. We can sit in the living room, telling stories, eating butterscotch pie. Butts pie? We could be like a family. Excuse me? The fuck? What the fuck? You idiot. You haven't learned a thing. In this world, it's kill or be killed. Oh, was the game supposed to crash? Does the game just crash?